Request of prayer you might have this morning. Glory to God, knowing that God answers prayers. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Any special requests?
This scripture reading is by Gary Gregor, also by sister's youngest son, his father. I don't know what happened, but thank God we got him in his apartment last week.
Okay. Amen. I want to remember all those that are on their way to the house of worship this morning, that God has granted a safe journey. I want to remember all those that are in hospitals and nursing homes and rehab centers and mental institutions, and all those that are in jails and in prisons. Amen. And all of those that were, just don't know Jesus as Lord and Savior today. Amen. We'll keep them in prayer. Once again, our scripture reading is going to be found in the book of Acts, chapter 12. Those of you who can, I ask that you stand with us this morning as we read, beginning with verse 1. Word of the Lord says, "Now about that time, Herod the king stretched forth his hand to vex certain of the church. And he killed James, the brother of John, with the sword. And because he saw it pleased the Jews, he proceeded headed further to take Peter also. Then were the days of unleavened bread. And when he had apprehended him, he put him in prison and delivered him to four quadrants of soldiers to keep him, intending after Easter to bring him forth to the people. Peter therefore was kept in the prison, but prayer was made without ceasing of the church unto God for him. And when Herod would have brought him forth, the same night Peter was sleeping between two soldiers, bound with two chains, and the keepers before the door kept the prison. And behold, the angel of the Lord came unto him, and a light shined in the prison. And he smote Peter on the side, and raised him up, saying, Arise up quickly. And his chains fell off from his hands. And the angel said unto him, Gird thyself, and bind on thy sandals. And so he did. And he said unto him, Cast thy garment about thee, and follow me. And he went out and followed him, and wist not that it was true, which was done by the angel, but thought he saw a vision. When they were past the first and the second ward, they came unto the iron gate that leadeth unto the city, which opened to them of his own accord. And they went out and passed on through one street, and forthwith the angel departed from him. And when Peter was come to himself, he said, Now I know of a surety that the Lord hath sent his angel and hath delivered me out of the hand of Herod and from all the expectation of the people of the Jews. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his word. Amen. Let us take this opportunity to pray. Amen. Talk to God about the things that you're concerned about. Amen. Because God wants to hear from you today. Lord Jesus, Father in heaven, oh God, we enter to your gates with thanksgiving, and we enter into your courts with praise. Lord God, thank you for where you brought us from. Father, we thank you for keeping us from harm and from danger. Hallelujah. We thank you, God, for not allowing the enemy to cause us harm and bring loss to what we have. God, we thank you. Hallelujah. And Father, in the name of Jesus, you told us that we could come boldly before the throne of grace, that we might obtain mercy and find grace to help in a time of need. Hallelujah. God, we had spoken petitions this morning, but yet we have unspoken petitions that's in the hearts of the people. We bring them all, God, before the throne of grace today, knowing, Lord God, that you can do exceedingly abundantly above all that we're able to ask or think. God, thou art God Almighty all by yourself, none beside you, none before you, none after you. Glory to God. We praise your holy name today.
Hallelujah.
We magnify, God, your name today. Hallelujah. We declare you greater in our lives than you've ever been before. God, thank you. Hallelujah. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, we pray for those who are traveling to the house of worship today. We pray for those who decided they could not come. Bless them, Lord God, right where they are in the name of Jesus. They're in the fold, God, so we're praying for everyone that's in the fold. And, oh God, in the name of Jesus, those that are sick and afflicted, oh God, hallelujah, our bishop, oh God, we pray earnestly, God, that you touch his physical body. Begin to heal, God, everything, glory to God, that's causing his pain. And God, strengthen, we pray. Hallelujah. Strengthen him, Lord God, in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That he might be able to stand and to walk, God, God, according to his heart's desire. God, in the name of Jesus, we sing the word. Let it move throughout the hospitals, God, the nursing homes, the rehab centers, the mental institutions. Let your word, God, move through the jails and through the prisons. Hallelujah. Let it move through the city of St. Joseph. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh God, in Jesus' name. We're mindful to continue to pray for our pastor, Lord God, and his wife. Our musicians, Lord God, the praise and worship team. The ministry here at Greater Jesus Tabernacle. All of the sheep of God, the people of God. Hallelujah. We pray your blessings, God, upon your people. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And Lord God, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We don't know, God. Hallelujah. How to truly bless you. So, Lord God, we ask that you take time to bless yourself. Hallelujah. Just so long as we have. We want, oh God, we want to see you blessed. We want to see you smile. We want to see you pleased with your people. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let your will be done, Lord God. We pray in the service this morning. We're asking, God, that you just let your spirit just fill this place. Hallelujah. And when we leave, God, let us know that